Inconsistent.
So look, he's like, I really like this chick, but she's going out with this cool guy. Leather jacket means cool, right? Alright, how can I win her affections? Oh. Pop this tire or whatever.
Wait, Keanu Reeves popped his tire?
No, he popped Keanu Reeves' car. Look, and then they decide we're going to do a chicken race.
A chicken race.
Okay, so basically we drive to the cliff, and the first person to stop loses.
God. Oh, this is a good song.
Oh,
we're gay for each other.
It's a good song.
We like each other.
That's how I remember the video, because when I was a kid watching it.
I forgot that was Keanu. Look how sexy he looks.
Oh, shoot, I didn't get out the car. I died.
That's a fucked up way to win the girl.
He's like, yeah, I did it. So what are you gonna, you gonna go with him now?
Wait, hold on a second. He won, though.
Alright. He's rubbing milk in his face. Look at this fucking guy.
He's rubbing milk. Why?
So this movie came out.
What the fuck was that? This thing was rubbing a glass.
There's another movie I've watched.
Glass jar of leche.
Over, again, over and over again.
I feel like you're exposing your inner thoughts to me. This is a movie, nigga.
This movie came out.
A preview.
If I remember. Or I seen it, but I said, not that it
came
out. I
want to hear it, though.
Hey, girls. Welcome to the bit. Oh, my.
See? See what's going on here? Similar situation?
Same thing. Yeah, chicken race.
This guy jumps out. This guy's like, yeah, I won, nigga. This nigga's trash. Oh, God. Bobby died. I think that's the guy's name in the movie, actually.
Wow. Bro.
That's hilarious, bro. I can't believe that's just happened. It's such a, it's so random. Anyway, that I seen this movie at the, around the time that the video came out, so I associated them together. So for years, I thought, yo, it's a movie, but Paula Abdul's in the movie, and I can't find this movie, yo.
Oh, so you tied those two things together? Yeah,
because I was real little when I first saw it, and I thought the movie was great. But for some reason, the music video kind of like, remember, you know, you're young, you don't know. And then, like, I don't know, a few years ago, I ran into the title to the movie, and I was like, this is the freaking movie. And I watched it, and I was like, this is a very campy movie, but this, because it has, I, because I watched it at such a young age, it's like nostalgia.
Yeah, going back.
So now I'm like, I like this movie. So the movie basically is this. I don't know if you're ever going to watch it. I don't know if you want spoiler alert. So the movie is basically, he dies in the thing, but then he comes back as a ghost.
Because, yeah, you see his wings.
Yeah, because he needs to accomplish something before he can go to heaven. So the whole movie is just him as a ghost.
Jumping out of the vehicle?
Yeah. So when he comes back, though, it's like in the 90s. So this happened like in the 50s or, oh no, he came back in the 80s. That's what it was, I think.
He something went back like that. Further into time.
Yeah. So I think the movie took place in the 70s when he died, and he comes back in the 80s to see this kid, and he has to do something with this kid. And then a secret gets revealed at the end.
All right, watch the movie, guys. Coming out in the theater near you.
So we're gonna, you gotta watch The Man from Earth and The Heavenly Kid. And that's movie recommendations.
Yes, we haven't done that in a while. What you watching? That's hilarious. This nigga is going through a midlife crisis, y'all, because he's going back into the past.
It's a good movie, honestly. Why does my camera feel like it's off? Can you tilt? Can you move it this way?
Oh, I don't know.
That's good.
Oh no! They see the real walls.
What is this? The table.
Now is it too much that way?
Yeah, just put a little bit over.
Can't see.
Baita, ata. It has a little criquita right here. I don't think it's gonna bother anybody, right?
No, no one's gonna be emotional about
it.
First
keep,
of all,
I'll just keep my hand here so you don't notice it. So, all right, I got a conversation.
All right.
What if a solar flare happens, right? And you're home doing whatever you do, And then all of a sudden, all the power goes out. Like a blackout.
An EMP.
And you're like, what was that? You don't know what it is, though. Okay? But I'm going to tell you for the purposes of the what if.
Thank you.
It was a solar flare that hit the earth, like an EMP. It hit everything. But everything that's electronic is fried forever. You can't make electricity anymore. There's not even any more thunderstorms on earth.
Everything that's electronic is fried.
It's fried. Yeah,
EMP.
Done. But like, even if an EMP hit, in a week we can make a generator and have electricity back. You know what I'm saying? But this one knocks out electricity forever.
So you're saying that if this scenario would happen, eventually we could just recreate a new generators, yeah. New refrigerators.
Yeah, it'll just start all over
no
again.
Shit.
We'll get back in the business later on. We just need to make some repairs.
It'd just be a hard reset.
It'll be a hard reset, yeah.
Okay.
But I'm saying in this scenario,
right.
It never. Scientists are baffled, something to do with the magnetic
the
field.
The poles switched.
Yeah, we're going to make up some fake science for it, you know. Some techno battle.
We're going to make up some sci-fi.
Some sci-fi. So there's no way. To bring electricity back, all right? So that's the wide picture.
Oh.
Now, the small picture is just you in your house. The power goes on. You're like, what the hell? What if?
So hold on. All right. Have you ever gone through no electricity?
Yeah.
For an extended period
Not
of time?
Not real no electricity. Fake no electricity. Meaning, I still got my phone.
That's why I asked extended. Extended period of time.
Yeah, we still got cars.
The fuck was that? Was that you?
I don't know. We still got cars that have electricity. You know, so even when the blackout happens.
Right, the batteries will eventually run out. Will they? Solar power?
Yeah.
See, I think that will be fine.
Yeah. I think when the blackout came, it was fake because, you know, when you go outside, cars are still driving around. You could kind of put the lights on your car. Because I remember going to my uncle's.
Generator still worked.
Yeah. I remember going to my uncle's block and they connected to the car battery, like lights, see, and it lit up the whole
area. What you're suggesting is that. For some reason, it would the best because GD niggas. Yeah, the best scenario to depict the scenario would be that the you know how the north the poles the polarities you know from north south they flip.
Yeah.
If they flip, supposedly again, I don't have an education. If they flip, supposedly everything that we have, your phone, everything wouldn't work.
Yeah. Except. Yeah, but eventually you can, you know.
Because when you say there's no more electricity, like, okay, we would have to step into the sci-fi because we know that we could use gas, fossil fuels, exactly. Nuclear.
So that's what I'm saying. We have to go into sci-fi.
We got to go into sci-fi. There's no electricity. And if you've been without electricity before for an extended period of time, then you're the only niggas that know. Because even us in our short little life, we've had batteries, like you said. We've had other means to make it. So in this scenario, some crazy shit went down, and we're basically, will the batteries that we currently have, like your 95%,
you know what? We'll make it so that we at least the batteries they last until they die, and that's the end of it.
Right. Okay. So to the point where and
even if you try charging, it doesn't want to take.
Doesn't charge. The generators don't start. All our traditional methods of
and that's how we all find out what actually happened. It's because we all automatically go online to figure out what the hell's going on. And we all get the news like something happened. There's no power on the earth. And then, you know, as your phone is dying, you're seeing people are not able to charge anything. You go on Reddit and everybody's like, nothing's working. Nothing's charging. I don't know what's happening. Once my phone dies, I'm not going to be able to access the internet. And then the government, like, there's like a alert. Like, please, everybody, just be calm. Stay in your homes. The government, we're going to do our best to take care of it. And then your phone dies. Eventually, all the power dies everywhere else. And you're just home and you're like, what do we do? There's no way to get communication from the outside world unless you're physically going there or getting a letter. And cars don't work. So now we got to rely on boats and animals, horses or whatever.
It'll get to the point where you would need to start makeshifting shit.
Yeah. Right. Again, but because you can't make a generator because it doesn't work.
Right. So
we'll try it just out of freaking sheer will. But eventually we'll realize none of this is working. We're going to have to use water wheels on the river. You're going to see that all over the Hudson, just water wheels everywhere.
Generating electricity?
Not generating electricity, but like, you know, doing stuff like whatever, grain or whatever. You know what I'm saying? We're going to need it for physical power.
For what?
for whatever you need it for. Wash clothes. You know what I'm saying? The thing is rotating. You put it in a little bucket with clothes.
That's what I was trying to depict. Like, what does your scenario look like right now? Your phone died. You know, you ran out of candles. You got to re-up on candles. You started to realize that little by little, the things that we don't really think about, they're passive. I don't want to say take for granted because we created it. What the fuck?
Yeah.
But slowly, the thing that it starts hitting you, like, okay, I do need to find a way to wash my clothes and hang it. So I'm going to get a clothesline and tie it up from one building to the next, like back in the day.
And I don't have a candle.
You remember? I have candles, so I have to go get more candles.
I never even get them. Like, how are they going to get delivered?
They're depleted. Because
think about, where's the candle company? I don't know where it's at.
Nigga, not
here. Are they going to be able to deliver it?
It's almost guaranteed safe to say that we don't have shit being made here. You know what I mean? And the shit that we do have being made here is like the shit to support the shit that we actually need.
Yeah.
It's not the shit that we actually need.
So what do you... All right. Well, how do we live? Right? Like, how do we... Think about it. The food has to get delivered to our city. They deliver by trucks. There's no more trucks. That's done. So the only other option is maybe a boat going through the Hudson? From where? Usually they come from the south. Right, that's where they grow all the stuff down south.
Yeah, right? South and north. Shit, we get shit from all. Yeah, yeah,
that's okay, but I'm saying, like, if it comes from south, that's hard with no electricity. It will have to be sailboats or rowboats, because there's no engines.
But first of all, I'm still in my little world scenario, and I'm thinking to myself, that sailboat, that rowboat that you're just describing, that shit ain't coming for a minute, nigga. Yeah. It's gonna be total.
Yeah, for the first, like, 2 weeks, we're still trying to figure out how to get electricity back on.
Right, and niggas have, oh, you got a battery? You got a battery, bro? How much you want for it?
Yeah.
It'll get to that point, sort of, not really, because most of us would have already acclimated to this new lifestyle. But,
and we'll still be holding on to stuff. Like, I'll keep my battery just in case I'm able to charge it one day.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm saving it.
Yeah. Right, because in case shit goes back, how are you going to know shit goes back?
Yeah.
But eventually we would start communicating, passing notes.
Yeah, letters. Niggas on horses.
Like back in the day, I was walking by the Times Square office main building right on 40th Street and 8th Avenue, but yeah. You know, big ass letters, Times Square. And I'm like, wow, what a waste. Yeah, niggas don't make paper no more. Nobody reads this shit. You know what I mean? But then I'm like, I'm thinking about this scenario and I'm like, them niggas are going to be booming because they must still have the equipment.
And they would have to be manual printing.
Like the old equipment.
Yeah.
They would be like.
There'll be horses all over the city, all over again.
Not the fucking horses, nigga. My I can't job, do the horses.
They'll add horse manure cleaning. You have to go with a broom and a shovel cleaning up horse crap all day.
iPhone.
In a horse carriage because we don't have trucks anymore. That means garbage is going to be disgusting all over the city.
Rats all over the place, all over again.
All over again.
Because the rat poison, that's what I'm saying. Nothing is made
nothing
here.
Nothing is made, yeah.
So, you know, when you said that, when you described that scenario of the rats and the horses, I instantly thought about back in the day when the roads were bricks. And right outside this fucking building, the roads are bricks.
So annoying.
So it's so annoying. But it gives me that memory. The stingy, smell-looking alley with the fucking... It's gloomy, like we're in Paris for some reason, and mad depressing. Like the sun went away too.
I think water might still work.
Oh yeah,
because in New York, gravity. It relies on gravity mostly.
That's coming. That's natural.
I know that on the towers they rely on motors that pump the water to the water towers, but we can figure out a way to do mandatory, you know, manual. We'll just get, you know, we'll connect it to something, put two horses inside of a wheel and have them just walking to pump the water up or whatever, you know.
Yeah, no, that
or maybe that'll be somebody's job, but it's all day.
So would that make this so we got water and shitting down.
Yeah, I think water.
Water and shitting is gonna be good.
I don't know the end of the process of the crap.
You could do the cacas in the
book. Because I don't know how intense, power intensive is taking care of the crap. We might have to just shoot it straight into the river. Because they process the shit.
Oh, it would go back to the shit.
So they would have to stop the process because there's no electricity to process it. They'll just have to just run into the river.
Don't they burn the shit? I thought they burned it.
No.
But it requires electricity.
Yeah, let's call. Let's call Steven.
We know people that know people that know people. You heard?
We know people that take care of the shit. But that means the Hudson River would be disgusting, covered in crab.
Oh yeah, the Hudson River would be.
It'll be disaster.
It would be like it was before. They stopped doing that in the 30s, throwing garbage and shit like that. Yeah. Back in the day, they started. And that shit is still.
Well, we have videos. Sometimes when we're at work, some of the garages have like a special TV, and we have a special channel that just shows like old school sanitation stuff that they did. And one of them is them dumping it into the water with a barge.
And it opens up.
It opens in the middle, and you see it right into the ocean. Yeah, disgusting. It's crazy. Think about that now.
Oh my God! It would go. Well, before it goes to that. Yeah, people will be like, where do I put this? No, no, no. We got shitting. Oh, right. The where it collects. Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. Think about the world. All the stuff you have in your shelf, eventually when you eat it all, packages are gone because you're not buying stuff.
There would be an exodus out of here, though.
Oh, yeah. It'll spread out. People will spread out across the country, 100%. They will try to move into rural areas more.
Yeah, but where there are lakes, more rivers.
Rivers, yeah, because that's what you can use, you know,
for fresh power. Water.
Yeah. And power, like, you know, when I say power, I mean electricity, I mean manual. Again, with the wheel, you know what I'm saying?
Locomotion through the wheel.
We can make a wheel and you can connect it to a system that connects to a
saw. Bro, we will go back to fucking steam engines.
We will go back to steam engines.
Think about that shit right now.
That'll be the most, like, that'll be the most power we have,
steam engines. Oh my God.
Yeah, that's what we'll be hearing. Whoa, right outside on the freaking train tracks in the city, we'll see that. Oh,
I kind of like it.
All those carts will convert.
I kind of like the
I kind of like the vibe, right?
Niggas is fucking
it's yeah. It's called steampunk.
Steampunk,
yeah. Steam.
Ahí, no lo dañe. Sigue por ahí, sigue por ahí.
If you look at this, the way this looks.
I always leave the podcast.
This nigga always walks away. Look. Where is he? Gone. Look at this. Nothing but his chair. Let's see when he comes back. Hi. He's back. He walks away. Why?
I went to go get something for you guys. So the experience could be immersed.
So steampunk, it'll be like things like this.
Look. Press up, you dumb. They don't see shit unless you press up.
Look, things like this. You'll see things like this all over again. Look.
Oh my, not the Lindenberg.
Look. Oh wait, that's kind of
cool. That's not the way you say that, right? I mispronounced that.
Yeah.
You just said yeah.
It'll be.
Shut up and look.
People be walking around like this all day. Look at this. I see. I don't got the Oculus, but I got this.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know.
I don't have the Oculus.
What is this one? Look, that'll be a feature right there. Looking like that. Everything's going to be manual. No more power. Everything has to be connected to some sort of sprocket.
What the fuck is a sprocket?
It's this thing. What is it called?
The locomotion? Gears?
Gears, sprockets, all that jazz. That'll be a feature, bro. Like this. You'll see big factories. Let's see what this is. Oh, I thought she was a robot.
You know, this is interesting that you mentioned this because I was watching an episode of The Frontier, the new Star Trek. The Final Frontier, right? That's what it's called. I was watching an episode of that
Final
shit.
Final Frontier?
What's the new episode with Captain Pike?
No, you know, it's not called The Final Frontier, but it is called something similar. It is called something similar.
I forgot the name of it. We're fans.
It's a good show, though.
No, it's a great show.
I like it better than Discovery. Discovery was whack, bro.
Discovery was somebody was fucking high on some PCP.
No, you know, yeah. Yeah, they wanted to make things. Idea. They're like, oh, let's make it, you know, conform to the modern way we modern think about things.
Pendeja. So I'm watching that series, whatever that we can name, because we suck. And there we go. Great.
Now we both got it.
Now we both have it.
I love it.
And you could type, but I just gotta. Anyway, so to the point, what was I saying? Oh, when you were showing me. I know. See what happens when I get up and leave the podcast? No, this is what inconsistent GED niggas look like.
Oh, he's talking to me.
Anyways, bitch. I'm watching the last episode I watched last night. The captain ran into an old friend, and their home planet looks like, you know, when our first president, Washington, that era where they wore the fake wigs.
Yeah. Okay, I remember, yeah.
What would you call that times?
Colonial times?
Colonial times, yes. But it was sci-fi, like they were in the future. Like they had advanced medicines.
I love the way that looks.
That looks so fucking good.
But that'll be, well.
So when you show me that, those clips, that image right there, when you show us this shit like this, that's exactly what I see. It's we were advanced, so we know what technology is. So all the old shit would look fresher. What the actual fuck are you doing?
I don't have control.
What is this? What the fuck is this?
Let me close this window. It's not
you
that.
Gotta close everything, my nigga.
Bro, what is that?
Shut this down. Shut it down.
I don't know what it is.
Close the window.
I don't think it's this.
Oh, my Jesus Christ. Bro, where that? I told you, he leaves. What happens is you leave all the fucking windows open.
I left
and
it
the ads are like,
you.
I have to come and
I left it for you. So that way later when you look at your thing, everything's already open. We looked at it.
That's over. That's gone. That's definitely right, gone and over.
You have to
over
Google everything all over again. All right, back to the basement. Here we go.
Oh, my God.
That was interesting.
Jesus Christ, bro. You totally destroyed the whole entire.
You got to cut that out.
What's crazy is that you see the volume over there for the desktop recording?
Yeah.
You have it so low, it didn't pick any of it up. So all they're going to hear is us walling.
What's going on? The power's
they're
out.
They're going to be like, this is really bad acting. I'm not going to look for those sounds to put them in there.
You know,
like
it's funny,
that music you played, I can't play any of that shit.
You know that episode, last episode we talked about the future car? If the power goes out, these are our future cars right here.
Oh my God.
This, steam.
Oh my God, bro.
That's going to be our car.
See, that scares the shit out of me because I feel like that's going to blow up.
Yeah, well, that's high pressure.
But meanwhile, we have high pressure happening
car
in our
accidents?
Cars right now.
Nigga, car accidents? Explosions, nigga. Boom. Now, you know, you might get a fire. Maybe a little explosion every once in a while.
But it's still explosions. It's
but
combustion.
This,
engine.
Bro, look at this tank. That blowing
that
up.
That last car looked dope.
Everybody's dead, nigga. Everybody's dead.
Shrapnels are flying right into restaurants, piercing people in their brains.
Oh, God. Look at this. It's like a train.
Oh, my God. That looked like Uncle Thomas, the Thomas the Train, whatever his name is.
But I should show the audience. Looking at here.
You should show the audience. Sharing is caring.
So what we're saying that's going to blow up is this one. Toma. You hit. You
that
hit.
Definitely.
If you up. Crash head on with this going fast
nigga,
enough.
The front thing looks like something that's going to blow up.
Yeah, word. But oh it's crazy because the way it works is, you know, is water with fire under it and it makes steam and you keep it under pressure and that and you make it, you know, manually force his way through something that makes the tires turn.
Oh my God. At least the roads would be smoother.
You know, less people would be in these and more, this would be more for transporting goods. Like people that you really trust driving and not just the random peoples. You know, we'll see a lot of manual part vehicles like car, like bikes, but like car bikes. Okay, bro. Everybody in the car, everybody has to pedal.
I was just thinking about the New York Times because I'm like, they would have... I have to hire a whole fucking network of people to transport these papers.
Yeah.
The latest news. God, they will come back so strong.
We would have to do away with cash. And like the way we have our monetary
system. Think about
system.
The New York Times because they have the ability to do this shit.
Yeah. In the basement.
Think about what they're replacing. Twitter.
Yeah.
CNN.
They're going to be right back on top. We're back, baby. We almost died. You guys doubted us.
Almost died. Yeah, we're...
They're still there. They still
got the building. Still got the building, you're right.
You know, that's where we get the term uppercase and lowercase letters from?
What?
From printing newspapers and stuff. Because the way it used to be was, they have a like a suitcase almost, and they have all the letters. And when they make a paragraph, they would have to take each letter and put it down and make it into a little thing. So
and
like
a little
stamp.
Block. And then they put the block
like
into the machine and it would stamp.
So
there.
The upper, the big case letters on the
that's
top.
That's fucking insane. You have to do a whole machine just to do one page.
Yeah. Somebody literally has to make sure everything's spelled correctly. And then it becomes a stamp. Okay, put that stamp on the third page.
That's fucking crazy.
Yeah. But the big letters are on the top of the case and the little letters on the bottom of the case. That's where we get uppercase and lowercase.
So yeah, that they would be the first job. People would be running to get jobs to transport
the
news.
A lot of delivery people.
delivery. I mean, all the bike niggas are walking now.
Yeah.
Unless they get their
niggas, a bike in the street would explode. People, everybody would need a bike.
You know, a little steam engine in the
between. No, you have to manually pedal it.
Yeah, no, you
100%. Everybody's gonna have to be in shape. There'll be more skinny people. There'll be more skinny people. Yeah, and then it'll be a lot. It'll be a lot of bikes, but also a lot of tricycles for the older people, the heavy people, the people that are like not healthy enough.
That's an Uber.
That'll be like an Uber. You see a lot of those niggas walking around with the bikes.
That'll be a fucking Uber.
Sit in the back. Those would be like local delivery guys.
Like, you know the tourist niggas that bike niggas around?
Yeah, those
niggas. Those niggas.
You see a lot of horse and carriages too.
A lot of.
It'll be this. The
roads would be fucked up.
Yeah.
For a minute. Maybe not.
I think so. Because there'll be horse crap everywhere. They'll make rules like you have to pick up your horse crap. You cannot leave it. Because if niggas on a bike, think about it.
I'm talking about infrastructure, the maintenance of bridges, tunnels, roads.
Yeah. It'll, yep.
Think about it, the first
like week or two, nobody knows what's going on the earth.
Right. But at the first 3 months, people will figure, this is it.
Think about it. You won't hear from the government for a month. It'll just be us talking around the neighborhood, trying to figure things out.
Yeah, I would say the first 3 months we've established communications between peoples. New York Times number one.
What is this? Oh, that's this.
New York Times would be the number one.
The whole time I'm moving, I'm like, where is it?
New York Times would be the number one.
Yeah.
The first 3 months, but by then we would already have a system in play for like, okay, what are we doing about roads? We're gonna have to do it the old school way.
Imagine the Verrazano, just all bikes.
Can you imagine the noise from the steam engines?
I know.
A steam roller coming to flatten the pavement and make a new road.
They would. Oh my God. It'll be trucks that deliver in steam trucks.
You know what we gotta invest in? Earplugs.
Yeah. It'll be trucks that deliver steam to a certain area, and then from that area niggas on bikes come and pick it up and do local deliveries, because you won't be able to drive that steam truck into a neighborhood. It will have to be little niggas on bikes delivering it with a tricycle with just crates in the back. Here you go. Like the Prime when they deliver the food. You ever seen them on the bikes?
Yeah.
And they have the thing
they're all over.
Yeah,
here.
There's
two hubs here,
so that means Amazon would do good.
Wow.
That is crazy.
What a...
Airplanes?
No.
No. Steam airplanes, nigga?
Not steam airplanes. Balloons.
Balloons?
With steam. Uh-oh.
Oh, God. All right.
You're in trouble.
No, my daughter. My wife just said she'd call her trying to cut her hair.
Nice.
That's what kids do.
That's what we do. Dude, girls, it's a universal thing. Boys do it, too.
Oh, God.
I feel like girls do it more, though. This nigga's OCD is on crack mode right now.
What is it? It's the table. It's a wire.
It's your charging wire.
It's a wire.
How do you feel about having to get rid of your... Well, you're not upgrading the phone, but eventually you're going to have to.
Well, I was going to get another phone anyway because when I replaced... Something was wrong with the phone, I think. Because, it's like water resistant. But it's not DK. Waterproof.
Right.
Because when I brought it to the water park, I think it got messed up.
This shit is dying on me. It's
well, you had that for a long time.
Right? I had this. I don't do the upgrade. I used to do that. I thought it was, I got off the Crave a long time.
I raised it rock until it dies. But I got this phone like a year ago.
See, that's not raising it because I take care of it. This one, unfortunately, made it out of the case one day and got a snippet. And from there, I've been treating it like a piece of shit. But I don't do the upgrades. I can't wait to upgrade because the new one is coming out. So I'm just holding off. And I'm going back to T-Mobile.
Hey, welcome back.
Because now Netflix is $21, so it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
And the service, when I compared it, is like, there's a difference. But because my son lives in Long Island, he says that it's not good over there. Verizon is really good in New York City, the five boroughs. And I'm like, that makes sense because they have more property out here.
Yeah, they're focused more on like business-minded people.
Yeah, but think about the technology. As it progressed, they would dominate in New York City. You know how much copper Verizon has that they own from Bell Atlantic?
When the power goes out, they won't need any of that.
No, those lines become relevant. Oh, no, right?
Irrelevant. All of it. All the wires. God. All the wires are gone.
You're hurting every side of feelings about this situation. Niggas would die.
Niggas would die.
Niggas?
In the first year, mad people would just die. First of all, every single person on life support dies.
I was just... You literally, like, what... Yeah. It was like processing while you were saying it.
Literally was like instantly when the thing comes, the shockwave, they're all dead.
Oh my god.
Everybody that's in the hospital, like working there, is like, what's going on? Oh my god, let's go check Mr. This, whatever. Dies. Dead.
No, but they would check him on first and be like, their families would be around. Like, how would you keep that person alive?
You can't even contact the family.
No, I'm saying like, okay, first of all.
If the family's there.
The family's there.
Well, you never know. Niggas gotta go to work.
Some of them gotta go to work. Right. The lights went out. I'll see him when he dies.
What I'm saying, like, they're not gonna be there at the moment the light goes out.
Right, because they're on life support, right? They would die right away. I'm talking about the other niggas that are on oxygen. Eventually, they'll be like,
help me, nurse. And they're like, squeeze. We can't do this forever.
Take turns.
Even if they take turns, how long until they run out of people?
Dead.
That nigga's dead.
There's so many people dead.
They're going to have to make a decision. We can't keep this up forever. If we can't get in contact with the family and let the family know, hey, you got to take charge of this because we can't. We have other patients to worry about. I can't have a nurse dedicated to squeezing this thing when there's other people here that are hurt.
This is bad.
Planes crash instantly from the sky. If they can't glide land, they'll crash right away. Chaos everywhere.
Glide land.
Yeah. Because some airplanes with their wingspan, they're able to just glide and land.
How would in any shape, way, or form there would be fucking aviation? There would be huge
steam. It'll be like you said, balloons.
Nah, it's a boat.
Everything would be boat all over again.
Everything would be boat, bro. You can't get air
unless I think we.
The only way we own the air is balloons, nigga.
Yeah.
Because think about flight.
I think though we do have.
Is it mandatory to have electricity to fly?
To fly, yeah, you need engines. You could glide with no electricity. You got to get up there. I think we'll see a lot of that.
All you need is fire.
But for the steam, yeah. But that's, imagine, nigga, a steam engine in the sky.
I don't think a steam engine would be enough.
Power?
Power.
Because it's heavy on top of that.
Carry the weight. Yeah. Like, it would cancel each other out. So you wouldn't have, it would be purpose. It would get in the air, but like, you can't carry much weight.
You know what it'll be? It'll be niggas sitting in airplanes. And then the pilot will be like, all right, 3, 2, 1. They push the button and then rock. Not push the button, but like light. Somebody in the back will light something. And then it'll just be rockets that shoot. Poof, and they got to pull up, go as high as they can. And then they coast the rest of the way.
Or they turn it on and go, the reserve pressure.
Yeah. So somebody got to be in the back, literally.
All right, it's literally like the espresso machine.
Yeah.
You do the part. I do the steering part. You make sure.
No, but imagine niggas got to go to Puerto Rico, so you got to be sitting back there. You have a whole team of niggas just back there.
Niggas ain't going to Puerto Rico.
That's what I'm saying. All that industry, you got to be rich.
Niggas is not. It's not even a matter of rich. You got to be fucking crazy.
Yeah.
To fly like that, you got to be fucking smoking some really good shit. You know who you are? I'm going to tell you who you are. Those niggas that went to see the Titanic. That's who you are in that scenario.
Well, okay, hold on. If the power goes out right now.
Oh my
God. Okay. How much money do you have?
Money?
Remember, the bank's gone.
Printed?
Yeah, like on cash on you.
Maybe $1,000.
You have $1,000 in here?
Like $800.
I have like $20 in whole in cash.
No, I got 12. I got 12.
Oh, 12, but you also have that jar.
And I got that jar but I emptied it. I started all over.
I needed this money.
I needed that shit. Touch the room. And I reset it because when I took the... So I took the fucking thing and it was like... It's pretty full. I went to TD Bank because you could open up an account and then they don't charge you the fee. So I was like, the $6 to open up the monthly fee checking account is cheaper than the percentage they're going to take me. Because I had it like halfway full.
Yeah.
Like I was going in. So I went in. It was like a good chunky change in there, but I hated the fact that they were pennies. Anyways, fast forward, I did it again, but with like a third of the amount that I had last before, and I'm going through the thing. I'm like, this shit is crazy. I'm never gonna put pennies in here. So I restarted it, and all I put in is the MTA. I go to the MTA. Where do you get those? You could only get those if you order it in the bank. Obviously, you could get it from the bank, but I get it from the MTA refilling machine because they reimburse you in dollar coins.
But do you still have the jar?
Yeah, so I started filling it up with just dollar coins and quarters, no pennies.
That's the money.
Abraham Lincoln, you're not the one, Abraham. Sucio.
Yeah, if I had to deal with just cash on hand, I'd have like $20, $25 in a whole.
That's bad.
Also, remember, you can't access no bank. You're done. All your money's gone forever. They have in the bank. rich niggas
that you gotta be like Melendez that's getting accused of taking briberies in the form of, ready for this, cash and gold bars. He had like $100,000-$200,000 in gold bars, and they took pictures of it. He has some other shit too, a bribery shit that supposedly he was taking on.
Who is it?
Melendez. Senator Melendez in Jersey. Anyways, I saw that in the news yesterday. But I thought about what you're saying, because this thing, looking at the gold bars, I was like, that's not the way I pictured the gold bars. The gold bars look like Animaniacs. You know what I mean? Perfectly square . I was like, no, this shit look like dull as fuck. How is this valuable? It's fucking gold, you idiot.
But think about it. Imagine you're rich, right? And your money's in the bank. So now,
oh no, yeah, you're done.
Now you have nothing.
I literally have like maybe $1,300 to barter with right now.
What you have is property. If you're on the property and that's it, that's your spot. Now at least you got a big property.
Bitch, you ain't got shit unless you can protect it. So you're that's in the saying. Property you're in right now, but it's not yours.
Yeah, but so I'm saying for the first few months, it's going to be like that. It's going to be like the zombie apocalypse, basically. Niggas are going to be fighting for food, killing each other for food.
Right. If you had money. Let's bring it back to the money situation. If you had, I have $1,000 in cash, U.S. dollars. You don't have shit.
If they accept it, some people be like, I don't want money. I want a bar.
No, but you have shit. Yeah, you have. I want your controller thing because mine is old. No reason, because there's no electricity. Yeah. But it's a stupid example.
You know, they're gonna be like, do you have any iron or metal? I need that, so I can melt it and turn it into other things.
Oh my God! Think about that right there. That's
another industry that's gonna spark up. The blacksmith, he's gonna show
the blacksmiths are gonna be hard body, and they're gonna drive vehicles like that right there. The vehicles,
they're gonna be the rich niggas,
those niggas right there owning that car. Oh, that shit look dope as fuck, nigga. Is that a beetle? Anyway, so damn, nigga, a lot of people would die. I would say it would be a year solid before
we start to figure things out.
We figure things out
like stably.
Yeah, it's settling in. The idea of what the fuck is going on settling in, and we're going, okay, this is the new reality of our life.
Everybody's gonna start farming again. Everybody, you have to farm
again. You gotta spread out because ain't nobody farming shit out here.
So New York City is gonna be all those buildings are gonna be empty.
That's what I'm saying. If most buildings in New York City are three levels, six units a building, if that's a regular for 60% of units in New York City, that's just one backyard for a family of six apartments.
Yeah.
That backyard ain't feeding those six
units. And not only that, think about all these buildings. If your building is more than five floors, that's too much to walk up every day.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not even counting the other percentage of buildings that are more floors. But I'm saying
all those buildings from the sixth floor up, it doesn't matter how tall you build, all that's going to be empty. Nobody's going to want to walk up those stairs.
No one's living in the projects.
Yeah.
No one is living in the projects.
You know what they'll do? They'll convert a lot of those big buildings to farms. But how? You need electricity still. You need light.
No one. Those are just empty cubes.
Nothing.
Of maybe storage.
New York City, like downtown Manhattan, will be a freaking desolate.
Yep. You seeing people would be like, hey, David.
Yeah.
Fuck is going on, bro?
It'll be just useless. That big building, the One World Trade, nothing. Useless.
It would be there for a minute.
It'll just rot away. It'll rot away. It'll all those buildings start getting rotten. They'll start every once in a while. You'll hear it and you look outside and the building just...
You think it'll fall? Why the fuck would the building fall?
Because nobody's taking care of it.
Why would a building need to be taken care of?
Eventually it starts eroding.
From what?
Just regular anything. Wind, rocks.
No.
Yeah, eventually it'll erode away.
No, it'll be perfectly fine.
No, it wouldn't last forever. Eventually, that's why
first of all, nothing lasts forever, right? Yeah. But
that's what people take care. It'll be a while, but eventually you start collapsing. Things will start falling.
The older one, but not the world, not that one.
Not the world, not maybe not that one because metal and glass.
That shit is solid.
But like, man, if a hurricane came through and windows broke, it'll be broken forever.
If a hurricane, I can see.
But think about it like this:
Mother Nature, or like, if we don't keep it in the sense of like weeds, because you ever seen that thing?
Yeah, but nobody's gonna go there. The weeds are just gonna take over
instantly. The weeds, and then it'll be destroyed.
So what'll happen is there'll be a storm, a window, one window will break, whatever. Water starts getting in there from rainstorms. It'll start molding up, and things will get weak and start breaking inside. Eventually, plants and animals start moving in there. Again, they start breaking. Plants growing inside of a building is chaos, nigga. It'll start breaking the building apart.
Plants breaking
because the weeds and stuff, you know, they'll start going into the cracks and growing and stretching out. And if it's, you know, obviously if it gets frozen water, it will split up,
right?
You know, after a few years, things will start cracking and breaking apart.
Right. Yes, exactly.
Yeah. And it'll just take time, but it'll
still eventually. That World Trade Center, regular degular.
That might hold on for a while.
That's going
to
hold.
But if the interior starts collapsing, eventually the exterior is not going to be able to hold all the weight.
All right, so if the fucking buildings are gone.
Well, either way, nobody's going to be in there.
Right, it would be pretty desolate.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. And then...
It'll be like we're animals. It'll just be animals living in there.
Wow, what a comeback for New York Times. Because I'm like, oh, you know, we have radio. Nope.
Newspaper, and that's it.
No, we could have radio. Yeah, we would have radio.
Why would we have radio? There's no electricity.
Right, the electricity. I'm thinking steam, and we turn the steam, but no, something fucking happened where electricity, we can't touch it. Oh my gosh.
You can't even have freaking like telegraph, none of that exists. It'll literally be people, niggas with letters. There you go. The letter.
That's what I was saying. The Times would make such a comeback because not only in order to distribute the news, you have to receive it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that means like.
That means it'll take days to get news from Europe.
We just got the latest paper.
Oh my god, something happened in Europe. When did it happen? It was 3 weeks ago.
The London tire. Yeah. Fell. Whatever. Shit is eroding.
It'll take weeks for us to get news from over there. We'll never know what's going on in Afghanistan ever again.
Do you think relationships would be more like we would spend more time together? And
yeah. People
would be more.
You'll be more intimate with your neighbors. That's for sure.
Yeah. You're like,
you'll get to know them better. Like, yo, we walk by each other. Hi, bye.
Come through, bro. I've got a turkey from Staten Island. Oh. That shit is fucking delicious. Come. I got you guys.
Yeah. You know what's funny?
If you have anything to drink.
Well, the other day I was driving.
Come through with that bottle. Yeah.
And I saw like apples on the curb.
What?
I was driving somewhere in Staten Island. I saw apples just on the floor. A whole bunch of apples.
The fuck were the apples doing?
And as I'm driving by, I look, and then I look at the tree, and there's a tree in somebody's yard, and these apples just fell. And I drove by, yeah, you don't see that too much around here. And I thought, I want to do that. I want to plant apple seeds all over in random places.
I want to do that with marijuana.
Yeah. Why not?
Seeds are expensive, nigga. That's why.
No, I mean for you, but for apples.
For me.
And I looked online, like, how do you grow apple seeds? Apparently, you're supposed to put them like in a damn cloth and keep it in your refrigerator for like 6 weeks, and then you take them out and they will start germinating.
Yep.
And then you start planting them.
It's also like, how you do it for marijuana seeds. Go ahead.
And I'm like, that may be something fun for me to do with the kids. Just plant apple seeds everywhere. Just
rent. You're gonna get it. So he lives in Staten Island. You're gonna get a ticket, nigga, from your own people, from your own job.
No, but I would when I go to the kids to the park. We'll go to like where the trees are.
That gotta be illegal, nigga, in New York City. I don't think you understand.
But
freedom.
You think a cop is gonna walk up to me like, "Are you planting seeds?"
Yeah, they're gonna get the cameras. They're gonna see your shit.
They're gonna see me planting.
You think that's legal, bro? Yeah. That shit is not legal. This ain't the fucking nature. We're ready to charge you just to walk around. We're gonna start charging.
They gotta catch me first. They're never gonna catch me. No, there's no cop.
No, but think about it. The congestion pricing thing. We're gonna charge you to move around.
Yeah, but then I'm going to even look for apple niggas.
They're not going to look for apple niggas.
They're not looking for apple niggas.
How the fuck did we get here from no electricity?
But what I'm saying is, that's you're going to see that everywhere. Niggas are going to be planting. The whole park is going to be full with fruit trees. Because everybody's going to be like, there's a big open. Like Central Park is big, or Prospect Park, big open space. Oh, we need that. We got to plant apple trees and stuff.
That's where a lot of niggas are going. Right there.
You got to plant. We got to start farming there. We need that land.
Those houses that are around those areas.
Yeah, they'll
probably are going to be fucking inhabited. Niggas are going to be fighting for that shit.
Yep. So Manhattan might be very empty, but around Central Park, they might be
packed. Because Midtown to Uptown is going to be packed. And in the middle of Brooklyn, it's going to be packed because you got the cemetery, and best believe they're going there too.
Break those graves, got to go.
Those graves got to go.
Get that box out the ground. We need that there.
Yeah, we need to make some ladles. Yeah. That's gone. I don't know where in Queens, but those niggas
are gone. And if businesses don't change with the times, they're gone too.
Think about what you're saying. There is no businesses other than
your locals.
Right,
but they will communicate.
And what are they distributing? The news and food.
And food, yeah.
What else are you distributing?
I'm saying supermarkets.
Right, like
it would be like a farmer's market. Everything.
There would be offices again, typing shit.
New York Times. So when you walk through New York Times, you're gonna hear that.
It'll be loud in the offices because it'll be a big, you know, I don't know. What the fuck?
Yo, it'll be interesting to like if somebody made a movie about it.
Yeah, I would.
I'd love to watch that.
I'd love to spend a good 6 hours in that reality and then come back.
I'll do a week.
Yo, I want to feel
it. I want to feel it.
Nah, son. The minute you take your first shit, it's gonna be, I'm out, nigga. Get me out of here, nigga. I need my phone, nigga. Especially y'all swiping, niggas. I can't. I feel old when I see
it. You know what?
Too.
Everybody will wake up butt early in the morning every day. Everybody across the board, because that's when the sun comes out. You can't do much at night. So you would wake up when the sun comes up immediately.
Daylight savings is staying. Yep. That's gonna stay.
There'll be live bands everywhere. Instead of going to the club,
niggas would bands. Have watches. All those niggas have had their old school.
Oh, this is gone. It's garbage. Right.
But watches would come back.
Yeah, watches.
Time
would, come
would
back.
Be a thing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's always been a thing because it's literally time, right?
Because what's wrong with those pocket watches?
Like, oh, I got the Star Trek one. I'm gonna be okay. Yeah. I gotta find a battery for it.
Batteries don't work.
It has to be one of those.
Those ones that they move. You know those that way, if you move it, it like charges.
It charges it, yeah.
It'll be those.
That's how it worked before, because how the fuck they had time before.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That would be the only watches.
This life is too much. I can't deal with it. I can't deal with this life. It's as we're talking about it, you're breaking other aspects of what we normally do as a society. And you're like, oh, hell no. Yeah, but relationships, though, would be on the up.
Yeah.
There would be bars. Bars would be around.
Local government would be way more important.
So bars would be around. Yeah. Not laundromats. Nope, that's your fucking, your window. Yeah. With the clothesline.
You have to wash your own clothes.
Yep. What, bars would be around. The news press would be around. There would still be services, right? There would be still doctors.
There'll
and
be a
accountants
lot of,
charging.
A lot of viverias everywhere.
What the fuck is a viveria again?
When they kill the animals first.
Oh, livestock fucking thing?
Yep. You'll see farms everywhere in random places.
Oh my God, there'll be animals.
Any big area where there's land, there'll be farms.
Yeah, there'll be fucking animals in the parks.
Yep.
And you would keep the gate in the cemeteries because that's how you could keep the farm, the animals in there.
Animals
easy.
In there, yep.
Already built for us. We did it before.
Yeah.
Fuck. The bridges will need to be maintained.
Imagine riding a bike over the Verrazano. That shit goes way up.
Oh, but going back down.
That'll be accidents. Bike accidents.
You'll be going down the fucking... That's what's up. What a fucking life. The only thing I like about it is... I can imagine the styles getting fucking crazy.
Yeah, people start changing their styles again.
Niggas would look so crazy, nigga. Oh my gosh. And then in the cultural part, the togetherness, even though there would be less people.
It'll look like New York in the 1920s.
Less people. Like, you ever seen the bathhouse on Union Street?
Yeah. That's where they have the Blink now.
Yeah, gym. And niggas would go, twice a week to take a shower?
Take a shower, yeah.
And they paid for that? They had to have paid
for
it.
I'm sure some gay stuff happened in there.
No, sir. There was... Oh, yeah, right. Because I was like... Yeah. I was going to say there's all men's side and all women's side. I was like, that's where the gayness happens. Where they're together by themselves.
Nobody knows what we're doing in here.
We're really washing. Jesus Christ. What a horrible situation.
We would have to get water from the river.
You can. We're shitting in it.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Everybody will be collecting rainwater. That's no doubt about it.
Well, would the reservoir system in New York City still work? Is that based on electricity?
I think some water, we'll get some water, but how much water?
And is it drinkable if the reservoirs aren't?
It's not filtering it, right?
Is it does it even filter it?
I don't know. It has chlorine in it, right? Doesn't water have a little bit of chlorine in it?
Our water?
Yeah. Don't we drink it? Chlorine and fluoride. Doesn't it have that in the water?
I thought they have that like in Florida.
No, I think we got that here. I don't know, honestly.
I have no
Either
idea.
Way, we got to start boiling our waters, and that's the only way.
Bro, let's take it a step back. We don't have enough wood for everything that you're fucking saying. We'd have to input it.
Yeah.
We would have the companies. So the niggas that leave, they could have barter with us. What are we giving them? Nothing. What are we giving them to get that wood?
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
What a fucked up reality.
We gotta leave. We have to have land.
So it's safe to say, it's tough to say because we have ports here. So,
well, guns will still work.
Right, but we have ports. So things, if New York City were to survive, it would be what it was before, where boats would be coming off the yin yang with supplies and goods.
I'm sure the government.
And that's what we're bartering for, yeah, wood.
What you got?
We got fish that just came from fucking across the way, mad fucking tuna.
And then the boats are like, we need wood to power our ship. We, yeah, need coal. You guys have coal?
And the transportation from the boats at the piers to where you're going, you know, if we're both traveling both ways, then that got to be all inclusive, you know, for the wood in exchange for the goods that we received from wherever the fuck. Yeah, New York City would still exist.
It'd be hard though.
It'll be
be interesting too, thinking about how the government would handle the situation. Because they're like, okay, we have a country. We have this big ass country.
Fuck the government. We're not talking to the government.
No, but the government.
Yeah, think about it. They're sitting in their office. Like, they're sitting in the government sitting. The president's sitting there like this. Hello? Hello? Like, fuck that nigga. He ain't the president. Everybody's just surviving. But that's what I'm saying.
Local government will take over.
Yeah. That's maybe part of baked in the thing.
But the first 3 months, a nigga from the Navy will show up. And be like, we gotta talk to whatever the
head of state,
the governor,
or the governor. Who's the
not
governor.
Even the governor? That's still too far away. That's all the way in Albany.
Mayor.
Not even the mayor. It would have to be so local.
Borough president.
Maybe the borough president. But think about it. How are you gonna run the whole Brooklyn?
No, the government would channel and connect, but in the first 3 months would be a lot of y'all niggas need to figure it out. The government is still trying to make connections together. You know what I'm saying? Like we while we're connecting again the government and going to our rudimentary ways, I hope y'all niggas survived, because it's you're pretty much on your fucking own at that point for a little minute.
Do you remember this?
I don't know. It's obvious that a zombie apocalypse is still worse. Hold on. It's obvious that a zombie apocalypse is still worse than this electricity one.
Yeah, definitely.
It's very obvious. Niggas is dying in the beginning, though, equally or similarly.
It might get chaos. There may be fights and riots. There may be stuff like that. But after a week or two, it'll die out. Everybody try to figure out how to live it together. Do you remember this show?
I feel like I do. Play the trailer.
I'm going to play it. So I'm just gonna
remember, they don't hear it because it's volume down.
We might fast forward to the future depending on how.
So you see the volume thing over there, all the way down there, it's all the way low, so I'm not gonna be able to hear it. And maybe we don't want to. You see how it'll go up, but it's muted on the things, so you raise it too high. Anyway,
wait, I'm just telling everybody, we'll be right back if we can't play this online.
It's Constantino.
Wait, that's not a trailer.
That's an episode. How is an episode 1 minute? That's a lot of wasted money for one sentence.
Let's look up a trailer. Because Jericho season one. Okay.
Jericho.
Oh, my God, nigga.
Kansas that witnessed a series of nuclear attacks that destroyed 23 American cities in a single day.
I'm like, what? It felt like it just... Do you remember the show?
No. What is that black line?
What black line?
Wow.
And left our town cut off from the world.
Do you remember the show?
I don't.
It was a good show. And they ended it too soon. I think it only lasted 2 seasons.
Maybe I did see this. All these niggas been on mad different shows, nigga.
Yeah. So basically what happened, there was a nuclear thing.
Pause this shit.
The government collapsed and all the power went out. And niggas, basically, this one town had to figure things out on their own. Look at that. Steam engines, like we were saying. They came back. This guy found a tank. Tank's dead. No, there's no electricity anywhere. You don't remember the show?
No, but I want to watch it now.
It's a good show, yeah.
If it's about this shit, this is a good topic.
Yeah.
Because do you think you would survive with your 19 children?
I think it'll be very hard. I think I can't
be passive. Stop having fucking kids, yeah. nigga. That's the moral of this.
You know what's podcast. Funny? In New York
episode.
In New York with the situation, it's gonna be hard. If I was in, I don't know, Montana on a farm, I wouldn't need 5 kids to survive. You know what I'm saying? Because you need labor. You need
people. Well, I mean, if you take those 5 kids and you move to Ohio with little Mike and make him your little midget slave, I think you'll be fine.
Yeah.
But I think if you stay here, you're fucked.
I think obviously it's going to be rough. We're going to have to, like I said, it has to be one of those things where as soon as that happens, I got to be super proactive.
A single ass nigga like me.
You know, be crazy too.
I would survive with no fuck. But because it's me, I'm also dead right away.
There'll be dead cars everywhere in the beginning. Just all over the streets, just dead cars. So we have to clear out the neighborhood. We have to get rid of all the cars.
Shit that makes steam. I would have to break my espresso machine and take the plastics out. All the plastic components to find the container that's made out of the metal. And I would have to rig because I have an electric stove. I would rig wire, preferably that material, because I know it could, or a barbecue grill grate. I would rig it so it could hold up the steaming container, yeah. to then put wood and burn it up.
To steam what, though?
Make coffee, nigga.
Just boil the water and pour it in.
I'm bougie. I need the steamed milk. Take a
job. I would just boil the water and pour it into the sock.
Oh, that one at all. Yeah. That's old school, but nah.
We actually have one, I think, at home.
So the reason why I described that, and it's funny that you laughed the way you did, because it's like the amount of work just to get fucking steam.
Yeah.
So as a commodity, as a single dude or as a parent of 39 children and growing, this is a million strong and grow. You know what I'm talking about, yeah, bitch. For you, you would be immediately going out looking for containers, yeah. that serve the steaming purpose.
I would. There would be a nigga that on the area that would figure out. I know how to do this. So I would make one.
How the fuck are you making? No, that's blacksmith
saying,
level.
No, that's what I'm saying. There's a nigga. Not me. There's a nigga.
There's a nigga.
That's like,
there's,
yo, I know how to do this.
Always a motherfucker.
He's like, I know how to do this.
Right.
And I'm going to convert this car. I'm going to get rid of the engine. I'm going to get rid of everything that's heavy. I'm going to make a steam. And I'm going to drive through the neighborhood.
That nigga right there is never going to go hungry.
No, in that's society, what I'm saying.
In this reality.
He just wants everybody to see. Look what I got.
Yeah, come check. He'll come have a sign. Me. I'm on. No. Yeah, come meet me over here.
Come check me. Yeah.
That's where my shop
you
is.
You need a car? Okay. No, I got problem. You.
Bring that turkey, though, from Staten Island.
I need you to supply me food for the next 3 months, and I'll make you a car.
And we accept babies.
Well, I'll take your baby. But that nigga will never go hungry, like you said.
That nigga's set.
I can make you a steam-powered bike if you want.
But
make
it into a trike. But everyone else, if you're smart, you would go, and I would try to find as many espresso machines as I could find.
Yeah.
Because then at least I have the main component that you fill the water with and close it, and then you have pressure.
Oh, but
learning how to take that pressure and filling my flat tire for my bicycle, I'll have to figure that out. Not that part.
Yo. Niggas would be all day.
First of all, you gotta pull the pin for, so you have to do that.
Oh my
niggas
God.
Is dying. Niggas is dying. Because again, I'm thinking about how am I surviving if steam is the only form of modern technology to get things done, or not even everything done. Then I would be hoarding. I would be going to coffee shops stealing, yeah. all the fucking espresso machines I could find. The biggest one, the better.
Unless you know how to make it.
If you know how to make it,
it's just
it,
a
bro.
Container, right? How hard could it be?
Nigga, you gotta create a vessel made out of, you gotta get that metal that hot. First of all, you think wood is hot enough to fucking form metal?
I don't know. Maybe.
No, nigga.
You don't need it like 1,000 degrees. How hard could it get to be 1,000 degrees?
With wood? A hella hard.
You just... Oh, I gotta show you. This nigga said,
not the fan thing. Oh my gosh, bro. Yeah, we're screwed. Again, I'm taking all the espresso machines I can find. Fuck, I feel like I gave everybody that idea and now I'm gonna be screwed. That sucks.
Is it this nigga? Hold on, don't look. Oh, it's not these niggas, no.
So, all the niggas that make shit?
No, but there's a real.
I got stuck a few times.
There's an original. I think it's this guy, Pernuf Technology.
The niggas that make the pools. Oh my god. And that shit at the end looks fucking, it looks like someplace I think it's fake.
I think it's fake. I think when the cameras are not recording, they actually got machines that help dig them up. Because there's no way they're doing all that.
Right.
Oh, this original nigga?
I mean, if it's fake, they're doing an amazing job in production.
No, that's not him.
This nigga's eating a cockroach, bro.
So why you show me that? There's a guy, and I think he's in Australia. He's the original guy. He's the one that started this. And he would, YouTube fake.
So, either ways, how did we get here? How the fuck did we get here? I don't know how we got here. This thing is typing. Yeah, so we're screwed. Electricity is important.
Yeah. Hell yeah. Oh, this is the guy right here. This is the book. Oh, this is the guy. This is the guy. He's the one that started this whole thing.
The trend.
He just goes into the wood in Australia and he starts doing this. He doesn't talk in the whole video. But if you put on the closed caption, you can read everything that he's doing. He basically writes in the closed caption for everybody. And he teaches you how to survive in the woods basically with nothing. He literally goes there like this,
pantaloncillo, shorts.
But he has a video where he shows you how to freaking make this thing right here. Or something like this.
Oh, to super concentrate.
To superheat it with just wood.
Sand.
And basically, he makes this thing that's crazy. Where
he'll definitely survive.
He makes a circle, and then he puts like a stick in there with a whole bunch of little arms, and it blows into the fire. And all he does is this. And it blows the wind into the fire. And he says it reaches up to 1,500 degrees. Something crazy like that. This is... And he does clay pots.
And so you do the cast molding for it.
Yeah.
And
then
you
well, he pull. Doesn't because he literally takes the mud and he right, makes right. a clay pot. And then there's a point where he starts to make metal. He goes into the river and he finds like pieces of metal and he melts them. And it's just like a little pellet. He goes, this is how we start. And I'm like, what? Yo, but you have to know how to do that before the power goes out.
So we would, that specialized skill, those niggas would be like gods where we're like offering turkeys from Santa.
They'll be the new mayors and stuff.
Yeah, he'd be like, these niggas, right? There'll be schools and those niggas would be the teachers, professors. Yeah. Like some of them would just straight teaching and making new apprentices.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know if you know, World War II, the fighter pilots that would fly and shoot niggas down. In Germany, they were like, okay, the best pilot, we got to put him on the front so you can kill more people, right? But America, we did it differently. America, we took the best pilots and we brought them back to America that are going to train everybody else.
That's the way to do
it. So they were making more. So that's the way the government will be like, we got to find the guy that knows how to do everything. We'll take care of you forever, bro. You have to train people how to do stuff, though.
Well, all right, listen, guys. So just make sure that when you go to bed tonight, if you believe in the Jesuses or whatever you believe or nothing at all, be thankful that we have electricity because you most likely would be dead in this scenario, including starting with me because...
Yeah, we're not surviving.
We're not being
I want to survive, but I don't know how to do this.
The fact that we stepped into the reality, think about it. Most niggas don't even think about this shit.
Yeah, that's true.
And much less are ready for it. Oh my god.
Oh look, bro. Look, see, hold on, wait. Before everybody goes. Look how much he says it is. You saw what he said?
800 to 1550 degrees.
How do I get that down?
I don't know, because you're horrible at this editing. Oh, right there, shit. Look.
Oh, yeah, 1550 degrees Fahrenheit. That's wood. You know, he doesn't have coal.
He's I still, can't do math.
But like he's showing, look, that's how he's cooking that pot.
Fahrenheit, wow. That's wild, son.
Bro,
that's my coffee. That's my coffee.
We gotta figure out how to do this to survive.
Should we try?
This feels like
First of all, we talk so much shit about things we're gonna make a pencil. Let's write a book. We're writing shit. We don't even have the means.
No, we should definitely. This seems like something we could pull off, though. Look. Oh, that's what he's making shingles.
I'm letting them see.
Yeah, he's making shingles because he wants to make his roof waterproof.
You think he's white?
He's from Australia.
Spanish. That's Spanish enough.
This is in Australia.
Oh, no, that's Australia. That's some white niggas.
Yeah.
Those are the kangaroo niggas.
So it's funny. So like, oh, that's the thing. See the circle thing?
Yeah.
He uses that.
And then he blows into it.
Yeah. So right now I got 15 with just burning. So imagine when he starts doing this. So what he does, he takes it and he puts it in water for like an hour to see if the fire took. Oh, look, this got too hot or something. He said.
Oh, not the.
This is my favorite guy. Out of I hate the fake ones. It's so annoying. To me, this is the real nigga. He's the one that started the whole thing.
But you know he still fucks with technology because we're watching this.
Yeah, yeah. Well, of course, yeah. Well, that's why we got to learn now. Look, look. See, look. He's testing it out. Like, he puts water in it to see if it's... Oh, he's making... He's planting. He found the plants outside. Now he's going to grow them.
You know what also would come back?
What?
Porno magazines.
Yeah.
It'll be drawings first. Yeah. Until we get
okay,
the...
Okay, we can't do pictures.
We can.
Can we? We could.
Yeah. Porno would be porno would magazine.
It'll be black and white.
Yeah. We bet you the most important part, so that's all that matters.
Yo, that's funny. Oh, those are the ones that are bad. He puts them in a pile. I think he breaks them up or something. Look at the little house he made, though.
Yo, what up, everybody? If you like what you saw, please click on some of the video links on the side. And please support our channel by liking, subscribing, and leave a little comment. And maybe we'll respond back to you. And hopefully, you'll be a guest on our next episode. With family living in the lower deck, I won't say names, but I was lame and I was spewing disrespect. Turn to God to disaffect, that's worth to Trump. Now let's inspect to interject on what the youngest spitting on, spitting for where the sacred texts are given.